Hey everyone, so today I'm going to be giving our front doormat a touch-up or a refresh. So I have had this doormat for well over 10 years and I love it. I haven't found anything that I want to replace it with, and so you'll see soon that it's just really faded. It needs to be refreshed. I'm going to be keeping a similar color scheme because the color scheme that it currently has matches my favorite pattern and color scheme of a fabric that I have for the house. But you saw when I thrifted those sconces that have like some violet or lavender. The sconces that I thrifted recently have lavender or violet in them, and so I'm going to try and incorporate that into this mat. So come along with me, let's give it a refresh, and we'll see how it turns out. Okay, so here is the welcome mat. It says home, as you can see, and it has a floral design. So like I said, I think I'm going to keep the home white. I'm going to kind of stay with the general color scheme. I think, like here, this flower, or these little pieces here, I'm going to paint maybe the violet color as well as this part here, and then maybe do the other one on that side, and then something violet up in the top, just so it to be cohesive. So let's go ahead and get started. Okay, we're going to get started. This paint is the paint I'm going to use to paint the front door. Just have to set aside time to take care of that. So it needs to be mixed up, but isn't that pretty? So I just need a little bit for this project. Oh, there's a little bit out of separation. I'm just going to leave that like that. And I have this Martha Stewart Maize color. Hang on. Okay, got that open. This is very yellow. That needs to be mixed up a little bit too. Here is the violet. And this is called Light Lavender, and it's by Folk Art. do have this red by Waverly. It's their chalk inspiration line, and it's called Lacquer. I've had this for a little while, so hopefully there's plenty. White for the home. I don't think this is, yep, this has been opened. Okay, so I'm going to put that right in the middle. There we go. I'm going to use this 1-inch brush for the white, just since I have. The letters are pretty thick. Now, I just rinsed this and scrubbed it with a broom, and that's it. And I have to say, the first time that I did this, I was really surprised, in a good way, at how well it came out and how long it lasted. So there may be some touch-ups that I'll need to do with black, and I'll do that at another time, because the bristles, you know, kind of stick out a little bit, and then I get some stray strokes. But, yep. Okay, so I'm kind of chasing the sun here, and my camera timed out. So I've gotten this far with the home in white. I went ahead and put some of the violet throughout sparingly, and now I'm working on the green portions, which I'm going to keep those the same as they were before. Kind of moving along. I'll keep this green, because this does look like, these parts that I'm painting green look like stems and maybe leaves to me. So, okay. I don't know if I want to keep as much red on here, like the red and the the yellow in the same places. We'll see. And I think this red is a different red. Oops. This red is a different red than that red. That red is a little bit more pink to me, which is fine. We'll see. I feel like this red is a little bit more barn red. I kind of feel like that red and yellow might be drying up, or not drying, but you know, starting to clear. I think I'm gonna paint that green last, because I mean it's that paint has been on there forever and it's been sun baked and everything else, so I don't think it'll interfere, but I'm gonna do it last just in case. Making progress with this green. Okay, I think I'm gonna turn this around so I can see it better. So, what do I want to do for the yellow? Do I want to keep everything yellow? Oh, I need to do that green. I want more green this time. Oops. When I originally painted this, our home was yellow. And this home is white. And our front door is going to be green. So I do want the green, you know, to kind of be predominant. So I'm going to go on over this one also. I need to finish the white. Need to finish the home before I continue with the yellow and the red. Just need to get a good, better idea. Thick. Which, if we would have used the house paint, if I would have used the house paint for the white, probably would have puddled down in the nooks and crannies a little bit easier. And I think, that foam brush. I'll be with a black thinner brush, more of a pencil type brush. I'll be able to go in and clean up all of the what I get for using my right hand. Okay, definitely. And I need a second coat of the whites. I don't think I have any more foam brushes. Well, we have a really wide one, like a 3-inch. Maybe I'll use that. I don't have blue out. Well, I have blue, but I don't think I'm going to put any blue. I don't have much blue in my house. I do have a little bit of blue on the sconces. And that my favorite fabric. It does have blue in it, and that's why. Well, I don't think I had that. I didn't have that fabric when I first painted this, but kind of wanted this to be able to go with anything. So, okay. So there's a lot of touch-ups that need to happen, but that's okay. So I don't have a blue. I don't know. I can always go back and add blue. But right now I'm not. Okay. I have some lavender. I don't have a lot of lavender. Just have some. I don't know. I don't know what I want to do next. So I don't know if I want this to be red with the yellow polka dots, or if I want the flower to be yellow with the red polka dots. Maybe yellow with red polka dots. And I'm going to treat this as a leaf. Okay, so here it is. This is the final product for now. Let me explain that. So as you can see, I did add a little bit more violet here. I went ahead and did all of the polka dots except for the ones in the middle here and that flower. All of the polka dots are the lavender color. I also added a lavender flower here, over here, and just to kind of balance it out a little bit. And then I decided to go ahead in with a blue, and this is kind of a tealy blue. It reminds me of a peacock blue, and I think it really balances out the color scheme. That color blue or similar,
I don't know what the proper term is. I don't know if it's the tone or, but that family of blue is in the fabric. So I think it helps with the cohesiveness of the color palette that I put in here. What else? The flower in the middle, I could not decide on what color to paint the flower and the dots. So I just painted a green. I can always change it later. I just felt that that is, since it's the only flower of that shape, it just stood out like a sore thumb to me. Now, I know people are going to be walking over the mat in the house, into the house and out of the house, but for me, it stands out like a sore thumb. So I just painted it green and I was like, you know what? I can revisit that later. No one's really going to notice. People might stop and be like, wow, your mat is so bright, or I like it, it's bright, or, you know, whatever. But, yeah, I kind of just decided to paint the flower green and, you know, maybe it just won't be noticed, which is fine. And I did decide to go ahead around the border and paint a, I don't even know if you can consider that checked because there's only one row, but I kind of like that. I might go around the very thin edge, outer edge, and paint that green. I've also thought about just going over the checked portion, over that border, with green as well. So, I don't know. For now, it's going to stay like this. I'm happy with it. I'm going to move on to another project. But this took me, I would say it probably took me a complete day with all the hours that I did it. I did over 2 or 3 days, but I'm happy with the way it came out. It looks so much better, you know, so much more vibrant, and I really, really like it. And thank you all for coming along on this little project with me. I'm trying to get better at the filming skills. I know the lighting was not great, and in several different phases of this project, but I'm going to be working on that. So thank you so much for joining me, and I hope you enjoyed this project, and I will see you next time. Bye-bye.